Hello everyone, my name is Vitor Eboli and I'm from PUC-Rio. Today I'm going to be talking about the work entitled Fatigue of Buried Dented Pipeline Specimens. This paper reports the results of fatigue tests performed on dented steel pipeline specimens that were buried and subjected to cyclic internal pressure. Hot spot cyclic strain amplitudes were measured using two experimental techniques: digital image correlation, DIC, and fiber optic Bragg strain gauge. Pipelines are exposed to external factors that could eventually cause damage to their structural integrity. Dented pipelines are considered to be one of the most severe yet common forms of mechanical damage. The shape of the dent is a very important factor that influence the fatigue life of pipelines, since the fatigue cracks tend to start in points of strain or stress concentration. Consequently, a certain strain distribution induced by the introduction of a dent plays an important role for determining the structural integrity and safety of the pipeline. The fatigue behavior of pipeline specimens with dents under cycling internal pressure loading with or without restriction to free deformation were studied as a part of extensive research program. The investigation encompassed the fatigue testing of 33 full-scale dented pipeline specimens divided in three groups. One group comprised the 9 specimens tested in air, with no restriction to the free dent deformation. A second group comprised 8 dent specimens tested while buried in the soil. The third group was composed of 16 dent specimens repaired with composed material reinforcement layers that have been tested in the air. This work only presents the results achieved with the group of buried specimens and briefly mentions the results of the specimens tested in the air for comparison purpose. The specimens tested in the air were loaded with hydrostatic internal pressure pulsating at 1 Hz. 6 specimens had 15% deep longitudinal smooth dents, and 3 specimens had complex longitudinal 6% deep dents. Nominal and hot spot stresses and strains were determined by experimental techniques like fiber optic strain gauge and DIC, digital image correlation, and by a numerical technique, finite element method. The stresses and strain fields determined from the nominal loading condition or from experimental measurements and from the finite element analysis were combined with different fatigue assessment methods. The estimated lives were compared with the actual test results. Since pipelines are usually buried in the ground to provide protection and support, a dent may experience significant resistance as a result of the pipe-soil interaction. The aim of the present paper is to present the fatigue test results of buried dent pipeline specimens that were tested with similar conditions to those tested in air, simulating the same conditions of a real buried pipeline. One of the objectives is to investigate if the contact with the soil environment plays an important role in the mechanical behavior of a dent and its fatigue life. The tests carried out with the second group of specimens were divided into two phases. The first phase was performed prior to the dent specimens being buried. During this phase, the specimens were freely placed, not buried, in a laboratory facility and loaded with 5 hydrostatic internal pressure cycles so that the hotspot cyclic strains amplitudes at the dense area and nominal locations could be measured by using two different techniques, DAC and fiber optic strain gauge. Full field measurements were taken using DAC to identify strain concentration sites that could be potential locations or hotspots for fatigue crack appearance. Fiber optic strain gauge were bonded close to these positions. The second phase of the test encompassed long-life fatigue tests. For this test, the specimens were buried and cyclic load was applied. The fiber optics gauge were used to measure the hotspot strengths and to monitor any possible influence that could be caused by the soil curvature, restricting the feed deformation occurring during the dent areas. The test determined cyclic strain values were used in a Kaufmann fatigue equation to predict the fatigue life of the dented specimens. 3 meter long pipeline specimens made of the API 5L grade B carbon steel with 324 mm external diameter and 6.35 mm thickness were used. The pipe material specified nominal minimal yield and ultimate material strengths were respectively equals to 245 MPa and 415 MPa. The actual engineering yield and ultimate material strengths were measured as being 316 and 420 MPa respectively, and the true ultimate material strength was determined to be 500 MPa. The dents were generated by forcing an indenter in the external wall of the pipe, causing a 46% ratio change in the diameter after the indenter was removed. After the 46% dent was created, it was applied an internal pressure equals to 0.68 of the specified minimal yield strength of the material. The internal pressure forces a partial dent recovery, so that the final depth ratio becomes 15%. The EAC analysis provides full field strain mapping to characterize the mechanical behavior and identify any critical points in the structure. The specimen's dented area were prepared according to the EAC standard requirements. To do so, the areas of interest were first coated with a thin layer of black painting and then white dots were added manually. Fiber optic Bragg strain gauge sensors were bonded to the hotspot locations of the specimens to collect strain formation during the test. The maximum pressure applied during the preliminary in-lab cycles before the specimens were buried and cyclically tested was equal to 6.2 MPa, which generates a maximum nominal circumferential stress equals to 0.65 of the specified minimal yield strength for the material. This limitation was imposed to prevent any undesirable dent depth recovery. After completion of the in-lab tests, the pipeline specimens were buried in the ground. The specimens were stored in trenches dug in an earth field. The stages of this process consisted in digging the ditch, preparing the washed sand cradle, positioning the specimens in the ditch, and covering them up with selected material. After the specimens were buried, pressure ranges equals to 2, 3, 4, and 6 MPa were applied to the specimens up to their fatigue failure. Two sets of results are presented in this section. The first set concerns preliminary results for the in-lab tests that were performed with the objective of recording the dent shape and the full field strain distribution using DAC as well as the hotspot strain measured by the fiber optic strain gauges. The second set of results correspond to pressurization cycles performed while the specimens were buried. In this case, although not for all specimens, only the hotspot circumferential strains were measured using the fiber optic strain gauge. Blocks of hotspot strain measurements and full number of pressurization cycles were acquired through the duration of the fatigue test. The end of each test was indicated when it became impossible to increase the pressure due to full crack having resulted, plus the consequent loss of containment. Performing the DAC analysis enabled the determination of the shape of the dent area by using the first pair of stereo images captured while the dent specimen was unloaded. It's important to note that these ectodeform shape measurements can be exported to solid models and finite element software programs to perform numerical elastic or elastoplastic stress analysis in order to assess the static and cyclic behavior of the pipeline specimens. The dented specimen shown in here was subjected to 6.0 MPa of pressure range. For the first 10 cycles while in lab tests, the internal pressure was increased and decreased in small increments so the DIC images could be captured at each load step. The DIC analysis also indicated the full field strain behavior during the cyclic pasteurization for all points visualized in the area of inspection. A more detailed inspection of the geometry of the dents and their most restrained points was performed by using an inline inspection tool along the area of interest. It can be seen that the maximum strains occurred on both sides of the ring formed by the indenter, while the valley remains in a practically unload state. Strains were slightly higher in the right side, thus, a crack is most likely to start at this critical point. After the specimens were buried, they were firstly loaded during 5 cycles with the same pressure ranges used in the in-lab tests. Strains at hot spots were monitored using the fiber optics strain gauge. One can be seen that the influence of the soil restraint on the deformation of the dent area is minor by comparing the circumference strains acting in the hot spot locations under the in-lab test and buried conditions. An important point to notice refers to the influence of the soil cover and its possible restraint effects on the strain ranges induced by the test pressure. Using the strain ranges acquired using DIC technique for the buried specimens, the fatigue damage calculations were performed using a conformation equation to determine the fatigue life as a function of the applied circumferential strain amplitude. The calculations did not take into consideration the mean stress. One reason for that is although the mean stress caused by the action pressure can be determined, the total mean stress is unknown due to the uncertain previous load history imposed on the pipe material, such as the residual stress caused by the pipeline fabrication. This table showed the fatigue damage calculation for all the buried specimens and experimental results for the fatigue test. It presented the fatigue lives predicted by a Kaufmann-Munson equation and the actual lives determined via tests. The measured strains before and after burying the pipeline specimens present negligible difference, helping to draw the conclusion that the soil cover did not restrain the deformation of the dent. The test results for the buried specimens presented that the DIC and the fiber optic strain gauge have a good agreement of the strain range measured. This observation is also valid for the non-buried specimens. Moreover, this table also gives the fatigue test results for the specimens tested in air. The fatigue life of the buried specimens and the specimens tested in air agreed well with the Kaufmann-Munson curves proposed. The results fall within 2 Kaufmann-Munson fatigue curves without the mean stress. This work has shown the highly successful combined use of 2 experimental techniques, the DIC and the fiber optic strain gauge, to accurately determine strain distribution and to locate the hot spots in the dent pipeline specimens subjected to fatigue damage caused by the application of pressure cycles. The full field DIC technique helped instrumenting the hot spot sites with fiber optic strain gauge. The strain measured using the fiber optic gauge showed that the deformation acting in the dent area did not suffer reasonable influence of the soil curvature. Moreover, it was concluded that the fatigue life of the buried specimens can be accurately predicted by a Kaufmann-Munson equation that used the actual material properties and actual hotspot measured circumferential strain amplitudes, and it was determined that the measured strain at the hotspot locations were not influenced by the soil curvature. Thank you.